Hello and welcome to the AR setup in Unity. In this tutorial, we will go through the whole process of AR setup for iOS and Android. And at last, we will import the SmartAR and build it to the selected platform. So let's start with the iOS. First of all, we need to switch the platform to the iOS. Go to the build settings and switch to the iOS. If you are done, open the package manager to import the AR foundation. We will import the latest verified version, which guarantees the more precise tracking. Let's import the ARKit XR plugin, which is targeted to the iOS platforms. As you can see, it clearly says that it provides native Apple ARKit integration. The AR Core XR plugin is mostly focused on Android platforms. As we've got all the required third-party plugins, we need to go to the project settings and XR plugin manager category. It's required to enable the ARKit field to make it active on application startup. Now let's get into the player settings. There are a few fields that we need to set up to make the AR work properly. First, we need to disable the multi-threaded rendering, as it's recommended to increase the application performance. If you plan to publish your application to the App Store, you can fill the signing team ID to automate the signing process, so you won't need to do it in the Xcode project later. I will enable the automatic sign, so I will save some time later in the Xcode. The newer Unity versions do some fields automatically, so we don't need to switch the scripting backend or architecture. It was also mentioned in the older Unity versions that these options will be obsolete. So in the short, the AR requires IL2CPP scripting backend and ARM64 architecture. It's already set, just for your information. Now let's fill the required permission descriptions for camera, mic and locations. This usually pops out at the beginning of the app. This field is not required, but I like to mute the other audio sources, so the only audio will play in the app. Also, keep in mind that the minimum iOS version is 11. And as you can see, there is a single architecture that I mentioned earlier. Other architectures are not available. And that's all, well done! Now your app is ready for AR in the Unity with AR Foundation. Now, let's import the SmartAR plugin, so we can have the real-time editor in the mobile device. Let's open one of the example scenes. Add a scene to the build settings, choose a build location, and there you go. The Xcode project will be deployed. Now open the Xcode project, choose your team and hit the play button to build your app into your iOS device. Also, don't forget to connect your iOS device to your Mac before building. Great, it's all done and it works like a charm. Now you can edit your scene anytime and anywhere with your SmartAR. Now, let's get to the Android. First of all, we need to switch the platform to the Android. Go to the build settings and switch to Android. When it's all done, let's open the package manager so we can import the required AR plugins. We'll import the latest verified version, which guarantees the more precious tracking. Let's import the AR Core XR plugin, which is targeted to the Android platform. As I mentioned earlier, the AR kit is targeted to iOS and the AR Core is targeted mostly to Androids. Also, don't forget that the imported AR plugins must have the same version. Okay. Now let's jump into the project settings. I will disable the portrait rotation because my application will be mostly in landscape mode. Now let's get into the player settings. First of all, the AR doesn't support the Vulkan GPU API, so it's required to remove this option. Next, we'll disable multi-threaded rendering. The minimum API level for Android mobiles is Nougat 7, which is API level 24. Switch the scripting backends to IL2CPP and enable the ARM64 architecture only. And the last but not least, enable the AR core field in the XR plugin manager category. We are done. Now let's import the SmartAR plugin to the project. Open one of the example scenes, add a scene to the build settings and deploy the application file to your mobile. And that's it. Works as well as the iOS version. I hope this quick tutorial was helpful and I wish you good luck with AR and SmartAR.